Good morning. Yeah, thank you for visiting our YouTube channel, and thanks for the support you've given us over the years through shark bait. Today I'm here to model a new shark bait and a zippered hoodie. No, I'm not. As I threatened, we're going to talk about Okuma rods for a little bit, and I should have been doing a little presentation on their rods on the PCH series, certainly, a few years ago. What I'd like to do today is talk really about the Hawaiian series of popping and jigging rods, but I want to back up a little bit into the PCH series from Okuma. The PCH is in Pacific Coast Highway. The PCH series really tried to represent some different technology. In the old days, with Okuma on the rods, old days I'll say 10 years ago, they bought blanks from us to kind of mirror actions that were popular on the West Coast. Specifically, Okuma purchased some CalStar blanks because CalStar represented pretty much the state of the art for West Coast rod design. Time advances, I'll say, Okuma has been looking at another company real hard over the last 5 years, that we've talked about quite a bit too, which was the new name for the old Graphite USA, new name being United Composites, and making use of some proprietary technology in rod design from those folks. Okuma has incorporated some of those aspects in the PCH series specifically. And on the PCH series, we'll see them make use of a spiral technique as far as the use of the carbon fiber through the blank. They also will be utilizing fiberglass in a unidirectional, longitudinally oriented mode, which is something I talked about with UC doing many years ago, which adds more lift to it. And the spiral wrap improves the hoop strength of the rod, which is referring to the ovaling of a blank. Bottom line, Okuma has been copying the right people. I shouldn't use the word copy. They've been learning from the right people when it comes to rod design. Now, Okuma as a company is Taiwanese based. And unlike many companies that build rods in Asia and bring them to the U.S. market, Okuma actually owns their plants, and they have control of the plants, where many companies do not. Like Penn, for instance, on their imported rods, they've got no control over the production. I can buy rods from the same factory and stick my name on them and be the same thing. I've done it. Okuma is a unique animal in that respect. They have control of their factory. The PCH series mimicking actions, mimicking design of US-based companies. And that's a good thing because they have the advantage of a price point that'll be less than the US-produced piece. The US-produced piece, better animal, no doubt, but great value with what Okuma's doing, and they haven't gone crazy in terms of pricing. PCH series, that's just like kind of an overall. But really, I want to talk about the jigging and popping rod because those are really, really unique. In general, what they are made out of is 24-ton carbon. These are graphite rods, but given the way they are constructed, the materials that are used in addition to the carbon, very durable pieces. And understand, Okuma is a real company, and their rods have a lifetime warranty. They're not into building something that's going to cost them money down the road. Their rods are built to last. So that's a big plus, I think. But let's go specifically to the popping rods. The popping rods, basically, there are two in the series. They're both spinning. They both are making use of Fuji K guides, not Alps, where Alps are used more on the other series. They went to the K guides, forward leaning, as you can see on the guides. These are a true popping rod. They make use of a split grip, which reduces the weight. And then it's a blank in the handle, like we did before with the Ahi Assassin popping rods. This gives you a great deal of strength and leverage. The blank from the blank is as close to a one piece as it can possibly be. And this section is all reinforced. So you're not going to have failure. This is not like a big five, two piece, blank into blank rod that is always suspect. These guys are not. They'll prove to be very, very durable rods, and they're extraordinarily light. There are two models in the popping series, and the poppers are all 8 foot 3 inches. And I should preface, one of the advantages with these guys is that we can get an 8-foot rod and it ships like, well, 6-foot rod. Or yeah, about 6 feet, you know, is the travel distance. So a lot easier to get with you, to take on a trip, to put on a boat, to transport in your car by going with this type of design. That's the big attraction. And that's something that, again, we'll say UC's been doing for a long time. They had popping rods and jigging rods before they were either on the market. Now, but this design is something we see quite often in the more pure design popping rods, being a two-piece form. Where in the U.S. market, we see a lot of one piece, 8, 9, 10 foot. You know, that's not something that transports very well. You know, it's very difficult. You know, this is a great way, a compromise method of being able to have a long rod and still have it transport well. Very, very light in the hands. I'm going to say probably about 14 ounces, maybe 12 on these guys. Two spinning rods in the series. One made for 30 to 60 pound line and the other 50 to 100. Now these are spinning type specs, so for you guys on a conventional rod, that light rod at 30 to 60 might be feel wise more like a 30, maybe up to a 40 in the world of conventional tackle. In the world of spinning tackle, probably 40 and 50 is where I would fish that piece. The heavier rod, the 50 to 100 spinning tackle, 60 to 80 is probably where you would put it. In the world of conventional tackle, it feels like it's a lighter rod. It'll feel more like it's, maybe a 50. I think 60 is a push. But it that would be where it would sit in the conventional world. In spinning, we want to have a little bit more whip to it. And the reel is part of the equation. And gear ratio, part of the equation. We want to have enough flex to really hurl out an appropriately weighted jig. So in the case of the heavy, we're looking at lure weight from 90 to 200 grams. So it'll handle your big poppers. The lighter, the 30 to 60 rod, there we're thinking maybe 30 to 150, 160 gram. So your medium size, typical spinning reel type size poppers on the lighter rod. Great pieces. They're going to do the job for a lot of guys. I wish they were available conventional. We'll keep working with them. Typically guys are using spinning gear. The amount of line per crank you can pick up being a little higher, get a little more pop out of it with a spinning reel. But we'd love to see these in conventionals too, given the travel potential. Now, the jigging rods. In the old days, I won't say old days because they're still current, Okuma Seabros jigging rods have been on the market now for a few years. And very inexpensive, very good Alps componentry throughout, split grips, nice reel seat, excellent rods, fiberglass blank, slow in terms of their action, call them a slow pitch rod. Well, not really. It's more of a fast. But it's glass and it's a typical jigging rod design, which means when I put a bend on it, it'll bend all the way through into the rod handle area. And that's something we see in most of the very, very parabolic jigging rods. That's the way the Seadros has worked. Now, the new series, the Hawaiian series from Okuma, these rods are different. I call them a slow pitch. A true slow pitch rod with some differences. Now in the Hawaiian series, the guys from Okuma did talk to, work with, depend upon local retailers and fishermen in the Hawaiian market. Hawaii being kind of midway between Japan and the US. Lots of times, Asian firms that are operating in the U.S. With subsidiary companies will use Hawaii as kind of a transition to coming to America. When I used to work in consumer electronics, JVC, Sensui Electronics, both companies would have a branch manager that would be slated to arrive in the U.S. market in, let's say, 4 or 5 years time, but first they cut their teeth in Hawaii, kind of as a bridge. And Okuma has done some similar things in that respect. They listened, and that's one thing we've got to give them credit for on the reels as well as the rods. They listened to the market. The jigging rods in the Hawaiian series are I'm going to say really unique as far as major manufacturers pieces. These are very much custom type rods in terms of their overall design. As you can see versus the older design of the Cedros, just look at the difference in the diameter of the blanks on how skinny these guys are. You know, by comparison, you know, it's a different world. You know, and they are going to be extraordinarily strong rods given the way they construct these pieces. Now, the other criticism that some of the folks have had on your typical jigging rods is that the angler has really little to no control. You know, the rods are so parabolic, you know, noodle sticks in a way, you know, that they're bending all the way through, and in an angler, you know, pulling back on a fish, you're really dealing with gain of line, not in a pump and wind. You're simply, you know, grinding with the reel. You know, the rod's doing little to nothing for you, bending that much. You know, in the case of the Okuma pieces, they still, we're going to call them a moderate bend. And that's very accurate. They are moderate bend. They're not super slow in terms of their action. They will shut off through this butt section. So the rod is not flexing all the way into the handle. You actually have a little bit of extra stiffness. I don't know if the camera can point this out with the extra carbon, you know, on the outer wrap on the woven material there, you know, shifting back over. You know, I don't know if you can see that or not, but that's part of the reason why, you know, these rods are stiffer. And the other things they do that's kind of neat, you know, on the handle, the foregrip is extended on the jigging rod, and also you're not putting your hands over that screw-in part on a typical reel seat, because the foam is over that. And this foam is a TPE material. It's not an EVA, not a hypalon. The TPE is more like a hypalon. It's the same stuff we use in making tennis shoes, so it's very durable. Split grip again, and extraordinarily light. These jigging rods go down to about 6.5 ounces in terms of weight. Even the heavy one is under 10. Very, very light. You just can't demonstrate that in a picture, but they are. Now, while the popping rods are only available in a spinning form, the jigging rods are both conventional or spinning, either way. So we've got our spinning guides, we've got our conventional guides. They both feature the split grips. The conventionals give you a trigger as well. Now, there are three models, or three blanks in the series in both spinning and conventional. So a total of 6 rods in the jigging series. There is a medium, medium heavy, and a heavy. The medium, and I'll go back again, on a true jigging rod, line test is not the important consideration. It may be a function of what is the consideration, which is the lure weight. Given that the way these rods bend, the intent is to impart action on the jig itself. We have to match the rod up with the lure weight. So the medium is a 60 to 120 gram appropriate range. The medium heavy is a 100 to 160 gram lure weight. And the heavy is 120 to 250. 120 may be a little light, but given the flex, you know, there is a broader range of application. So the heavy 120 to 250, none of these are set up for 300 to 500 grams. That's going to be a different rod. But in this more useful range, especially for guys fishing 300 feet and less, 250 may be as much as you need to go. You're well covered between those three rods in most any test. Let's see, what else can we say about these guys? Warranty-wise, lifetime, the length on the jigging rods, 6'3". I think that's pretty close to me. So 6'3" versus about a little over 8 feet. I think it's 8'3" again on the popping series, the two popping rods. All in all, the Hawaiian series represents some really, really good stuff from Okuma. It's quite a departure from, the PCHs in terms of that overall design and the skinniness of the blanks. The PCHs represent some excellent pieces, as do these. As far as pricing go, the jigging rods, very attractive. They're two bills, $200 or less. And the poppers, in the mid twos. So very realistic in terms of the pricing. It's a very good alternative, Yeah, if you're not going to spring for the bucks to go for a USA made rod, if you're going to get something that's an import, Okuma offers, I think, some of the best rods out there. Given the pricing and the fact that it's an import versus a domestically produced piece. Daiwa certainly did a nice job with the Proteus series, but I think the Okumas even take that a step further. And again, they're learning from the right people, just like they did on the reels. They've learned from some of the best designs out there, and that's really is United Composites. So it's a pat on the back to United Composites that they now have become the company that other companies want to copy. I told you so. Anyway, thank you for watching. If you have a chance to stop by the store and put a bend on these things, I think you'll be impressed with them. If not, you have to order them online. Trust the actions are right for the application. If you're tossing poppers, definitely the Hawaiian popping rods hit that real well, and they do it for a reasonable price. And same with the jigging rods. And I will say, there are some other pieces from some factories known, some factories that are unstated, producing rods like this from Asia, being handled by some smaller players in the market, that, $400, $500, come on. For a Chinese-made imported rod or a Korean-made imported rod, there's an awful lot of water in that product. Okuma is a big entity. They're a huge company, and they come to the market aggressively. They certainly have economies of scale. They're looking at price points. They're looking at putting as much value in the product as they can for a given price. They look really, really good, and I can't see a reason to look at some of the other stuff out there that's priced so doggone high for what it is. These are very good rods. Design-wise, I'll put them up against anything in that style of rod, and they come in there about a half the price from what we're seeing. I'd like to see some heavier ones in the jigging side. I'd like to see some pieces that handle that 300 to 500 gram area, given for our local bluefin, and the success guys have had out here with that type of jig used. But if you're running less than 300 gram, I think Okuma has it nailed. So thank you for watching. Appreciate the support. And we'll see you next time. Again, thanks for watching. Thanks for supporting Shark Tank. Bye-bye.